Basic Database Searching, CINAHL. One of the most widely used tools for finding evidence to support your projects is a library database. These databases are collections of books, documents, and mainly journal articles from scholarly publications. The library subscribes to a variety of databases in a broad range of subjects. There are several ways to access PNW databases. One method is to begin at the library homepage. Here you'll find a quick search box for searching the library catalog. Immediately below the search box, you'll see a link for databases. Clicking here brings up an A to Z list of databases that the library subscribes to. You can see that we currently have access to nearly 200 databases. Using this drop-down subjects box, you can see that our databases cover a wide range of disciplines. I'll scroll down to nursing. And now I can see a list of over 20 resources that relate to nursing topics. Two of the largest and most popularly used resources in nursing and allied health services are CINAHL and Medline. This quick video will demonstrate some basic searches using CINAHL. The letters in the database name stand for Cumulative Index to Nursing and Allied Health Literature. This tells us that CINAHL focuses on nursing issues, while a database like Medline covers a broader scope of medical topics. So nurses and nursing students are the intended audience for CINAHL. CINAHL comes to PNW on the EBSCOhost platform. EBSCO is a vendor that supplies several academic databases to us, including resources for business, art, philosophy, etc. When you open the CINAHL database, you see a basic search screen. Here you can type in keywords to search. For this demonstration, I'll search for articles relating to opioids. My basic search for opioids, without using any limiters, has provided almost 40,000 results. Since that number is so high, I can look at some limiters to help focus my search a little bit more. You'll see some examples of limiters over in the left margin. My recommendation, however, is to switch to a search screen that will display the full range of limiters at our disposal. For this, I'm going to click on the Advanced Search link located directly beneath the search box. In this view, instead of that single search box, I now have a set of three stacked search boxes. I'll talk more about using these boxes to construct a Boolean search strategy in a separate advanced search video. But for now, we can slide a little lower on the page so that you can see that there are many options here to help focus our search. Using this publication date field, I can specify a date range. In nursing, we often hope to find resources within about 5 to 7 years, but in this case, I know that opioid addiction has been a really hot topic recently, so I'm actually going to search for articles within the last year. I also have other options I can select. For example, I can specify that CINAHL only show me articles from peer-reviewed journals. Some journal publishers have a policy of sending submitted articles out to peers or experts in the author's field to review them before publication. So peer-reviewed journals rank higher on the scale of reliability. I can check this box here to limit my search to articles from peer-reviewed journals only. Another useful option is this checkbox to limit my search to articles in English. CINAHL does contain some international journals, so by checking this box, I'm going to exclude any articles in Korean or Portuguese, etc. If your assignment requires you to use research studies as opposed to articles, you can use this checkbox. You can leave the box unchecked if you're open to including other type of documents like informative articles, secondary reports, letters to the editor, commentary, etc. Feel free to experiment with other types of limiters on this page, which include things like geographic limiters, age group limiters, publication type limiters, etc. One limiter that I do not recommend is the full text checkbox. I'll explain why in a moment. But now, sliding back up to the top of the page, I'll repeat my search for opioids. I now have a set of over 2,000 results. You can see that the limiters that I applied, which appear over here in the left margin, have already narrowed my research results down from over 40,000, nearly 40,000, down to 2,000. Our result list here displays articles 10 per page, but you can use this drop-down box here to expand that to 20, 50, or more articles in one view. And scanning these results, we can see the name of the article in blue, followed by the typical citation information for that entry. The author names, journal name, volume, issue, page number, etc. In most cases, this entry will also show a red and white PDF full text icon. Clicking on full text will bring up a PDF display of the article that will include headers, footers, page numbers, date, etc. We'll also see any charts, tables, or photographs that were included in the original article. In some cases, however, instead of the PDF full text icon, you may see a phrase that says check for full text availability. This means that the publisher of that particular journal has not given copyright permission to CINAHL to display the full text of their article for free. In this case, CINAHL is offering to check other PNW subscriptions to see if it can find full text in another database. In my experience, this works at least half the time. In the case of this article, when I ask CINAHL to check for full text availability elsewhere, let's see what happens. Oh, I can see that it's found availability for me through the Wiley Online Library. When I click on this blue link, you can see that my EBSCO tab remains open at the top, but a new tab is also opened. And here we have the Wiley Online Library database. Here's a summary page with an abstract of the article we're seeking. And to open full text, I'll look for that red and white icon or the initials PDF right here. Returning to our results list, you may recall that when we looked at all those limiters available on the advanced search page, I recommended that in most cases you should not use that full text only limiter. And this is a good example of why. If I had used that checkbox to tell CINAHL to display only full text articles, my results would not include these articles with the check for full text availability link. My results would only include articles that have that PDF icon. Therefore, I'd be missing out on the opportunity to see some very useful articles on my topic. Of course, there are some cases when the research results are so numerous that you can afford to limit your search and still have a sufficient number of articles to choose from. For example, in this current search, I can now look for the full text limiter right here on the left side and click this checkbox. That will eliminate all articles that don't have an immediate PDF icon in CINAHL. So now those 2,000 articles have been reduced to a little over 400. I'm confident that this is going to be plenty of results for my project, but in some cases, using that full text limiter will reduce your results to a really insufficient number. So keep in mind as an option that you use only after your initial search produces a very large number of results. I have just a few additional basic search tips. As you scan your list of results, you'll see two small symbols over in the right margin. The first looks like a magnifying glass. Hovering over the symbol brings up a pop-up box that in most cases will display an abstract of the article. That's useful. Right next to it is a blue folder. You can use this folder to temporarily save articles that might fit your research purposes. If you scan a page or two of your results and mark several articles that you think are worth taking a closer look at, you can then scroll up to the top of the page and click on this folder icon in the blue bar at the top. Clicking on that folder displays the articles that you've marked to save. From here, you can use these symbols over on the right-hand side to save, print, or email the articles to yourself. Again, this is only a temporary save. If you exit the database and return later, they will no longer appear in your folder. If you'd like to permanently save articles, you can click on the sign-in link to create a personal account with EBSCO. This should give you an idea of the broad scope of the CINAHL database, which contains over 4 million entries. We've also demonstrated how using limiters can help refine your search. For more information, see the video titled Advanced Database Searching CINAHL. Thank you.